Good morning. This is Seed of Word in Ministry, and I am Ometta.
Sometimes you have to speak victory during the test, and no matter how you feel, speak the word and you will be healed. Speak over yourself, courage yourself.
Amen. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. I want to share with you some of my new things I wanted to do for 2023. I'm thankful for the 69 subscribers that I have. And I not only want to give you the word of God, but I also would like to give out some gifts this year. And that would be a $25 gift card. Some of the things associated with it is you must not be in my household. You must be the fifth caller. You must be a subscriber. And you must answer the question correctly. That's for $25 card. And I will send it to you at the end of this episode. I will leave you with my phone number. The fifth caller, I'll repeat this at the end. Amen. Sometimes we have to encourage ourselves. Amen. Amen. Sometimes that's exactly what we have to do. We have to encourage ourselves in the Lord. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Remove from us all stumbling blocks that render us unable to follow you. Deliver us from the mindset that causes us to go back on your spoken word. Bring healing, Lord, to those who are suffering from the loss of loved ones. Keep us protected under the shadow of your wings. Create in us a clean heart and a right spirit in the name of Jesus. Touch Damar. I have a cousin that needs prayer. Lord God, you know those that are suffering and going through things. I ask God, in the name of Jesus, by the power of your word and your blood, touch, heal and deliver in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Today I want to talk about resolution and unknown reservations. Resolution and unknown reservations. I always like to look up the word first. Resolution is a strong determination to do or not do something based on whether it is good or bad for you. It's always to resolve something, a resolution. Reservation is to set something aside, not evaluating whether it's good or bad for you. And also having the mindset way, way, way back in our subconscious that we're really not going to do it. Amen. We're going to lay it up. My husband and I for years have gone to PA for Christmas. It is where his biological father and brother lived, whose birthdays are on Christmas Eve. In our preparation, we would make a hotel reservation. Today, I want to share some thoughts on resolution with unknown reservations. I've always been asked, by the time it was getting close to New Year's, what is your resolution? And I would answer something I wanted to let go of. At least I thought I did. Under my verbal proclamation, there was always a reservation. I did not realize that deep down inside, I was still planning to go back to whatever it was I was going to give up. It was just temporarily giving it up. If the truth be told, some of those things I was giving up or wanted to give up or said I wanted to give up was really hurting my body. The Bible teaches us that all unrighteousness is sin. I don't know what's in the mind of other people in reference to resolution, but in mind, I always had a time limit. I will give up so-and-so for a weekend. I will give up so-and-so for a week. I will give up so-and-so for a month. But I never figured in my resolution forever. Some of my resolutions should have had a time limit. Some should not have, and they should have been forever, like salt. The enemy that affects my blood pressure, that can lead to increase in blood pressure, that can lead to kidney problems, that can lead to death. I did not need to reserve it. I needed a new mindset, a complete change of mind about the use of salt for me. How about my resolution to lose weight? That always ended up with gaining more weight. Looking at Romans 7, it says, "Know ye not my brethren, for I speak to them that know the law, how that the law hath dominion over man as long as he liveth." I knew what I was supposed to do, and it was a law unto me, according to my doctors, and I could agree to it myself. But emotionally, I wasn't ready to give up. I was not ready to make a true resolution. I knew what it could do, salt. And it was not good for me either emotionally, health-wise, or spiritually. I really needed to give it up completely, but I had a reservation. I finally came to the conclusion, for me, I'm saying, that I don't need to make a resolution. But I need to make goals. And so this year, I made a list of goals. Amen. Never to go back to to decrease some of them. Like, I'm fasting. I want to fast. Fasting is good for us. According to the Bible, it brings God closer as we deny our flesh. And I believe through fasting, God will give me the tongue of the learned. Amen. Listen to the words of Isaiah 50. The Lord God have given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak a word in season to him that is weary. He wakeneth me morning by morning. He waketh my ear to hear as the learned. What'd you say? Amen. The Lord God have opened mine ear, and I was not rebellious, neither turned away back. For the Lord God will help me. Therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like flint, and I know that I should not be ashamed. In fasting, you can set your face like flint, making a fast. A part of my goal will become more beneficial without a reservation. The law of fasting before the Lord will give me the tongue of the learned for myself as well as for others. Bless me, so that those around me are blessed. It's a song I just fell in love with. For me this year, it is Out with the Resolutions and In with Setting Priority Goals. Well, let me share my goals. One of them is to read a book, read a chapter in the Bible before I go on to my Just Show Up book club. It's a book club that I do twice a week. Another one was to take sweets. I only eat sweets on the weekend and with temperance. To eat more vegetables, to do my elliptic foot controller 3 times a week, read the daily verse every day, but also read the chapter and write a summary. And the one that's most of all that I used the song for was to encourage myself. There are times when no one is around and you can't get in touch with the pastor and your girlfriend's gone on vacation. You need to be able to encourage yourself. God is a good God and He's worthy to be praised. Amen. That is what I wanted to share today, because many people have started saying their resolutions. I want you to take a look at that resolution and decide if it just needs to be a goal that you intend to keep. And you're asking God to strengthen you and empower you to continue the process of that goal. I had my last sweet on Monday, and hopefully I won't pick up another sweet until this weekend. That is my proclamation and determination, as well as to start working on the others. Sometimes your resolution is done slowly. Well, I want to remind you again of the Bible trivia. It starts today. And again, it can't be somebody in my household. It must be the fifth caller. It must be a subscriber. And you must answer the question correctly. I know you can use a $25 gift card for something, if not but to save to give to somebody else for their birthday or a special present. All right, are you ready for the question? The question is, how do you encourage yourself? How do you encourage yourself? Father, in the name of Jesus, look down upon the subscribers and those that listen to this YouTube. May they too come to the understanding that some things that we put aside and lesson and all of that, we really need to give up. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. My phone number is 443-416-4701. Remember, it's the fifth caller. Over yourself. God loves you, and so do I. Keep masking, keep distancing. The virus is still out there. Seek God about as to whether you should get the virus vaccination or not. Work out your own soul salvation with trembling and fear, and check out your own resolutions. Be good, have a blessed weekend. Go to church if you can. Give God praise for His goodness and mercy, how He kept you over the past year. In Jesus' name, amen.